Elhamdülillah ve salatu ve selam ala Resulillah. The Prophet sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem mentioned in the hadith of Abu Yahya Suhayb ibn Sinan collected in Sahih Muslim, he said, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلُّهُ خَيْرٌ وَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا لِمُؤْمِنِ. Amazing is the situation of the believer, his circumstance is always good, and that's only for a believer. And so the believer's circumstance, his situation, his outlook, his feelings and emotions and his opinion on any situation that happens should always be different from the rest of the world. And that's because his iman makes a difference. The idea that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in control, the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, is the most merciful, the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Hakim, that everything that he does with wisdom, that resonates with the believer. And so instead of becoming hysterical and anxious as other people do, the believer looks for the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He looks for the wisdom of Allah's decision, what can be gained from this, and what are the positive aspects that can happen. And the paper that I was blessed to write for Yaqeen Institute, Al-Yaqeen Institute, dealing with the blessing of family, seeks to focus on that very issue, that we take this moment of anxiousness, this moment of pandemic, and we begin to look at it as something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed out of His mercy and His goodness and His wisdom. And we begin to look for the positive aspects of what has been decreed. And from the positive aspects that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed to occur and to emerge from this tribulation and this trial is the fact that people have more time to spend with their families. And it might not on the surface look at look like a blessing, but the idea that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us time and the opportunity to spend more time with those that we love, to perhaps nurture relationships that we had been negligent of, and to encourage and teach our families those things that will allow us to see their happiness and allow us ourselves to be pleased with them. Because nothing is more beloved to a believer than seeing those nearest to him and those that he loves worship. And so being able to spend those experiences and spend this time praying with one another, reminding one another about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and setting a course towards gaining Allah's love and pleasure, it's something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the time to be able to work on. Not only that, but that we also make the most of these experiences by doing things for one another, by serving one another, which was the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as mentioned by Aisha radiallahu anha, when she was asked, what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam do when he was at home? She said, radiallahu anha, كان في خدمتي أهله. He was in the service of his family. But when it was time for prayer, he would leave for prayer. And so look at that balance, the balance of worship and the balance of family service. And this is the example that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has left for us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that his example is the best example for the one who wants a close relationship with Allah and a good return in the hereafter, and wants to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Allah to give him success to do that. Allah mentions in Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter number 33 of the Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. You have an excellent example in the Messenger of Allah for whoever hopes to draw near to Allah, whoever hopes for a good return on the Day of Judgment, and whoever desires to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much. And so I hope that this paper that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed me to write, and that Al-Yaqeen Institute has given me the opportunity to write, I hope that it conveys that message in the clearest way possible. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless me and my family, and you and your family to benefit from it in the best way possible. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته